So let's talk about hot flashes. I've done quite a few videos on hot flashes from different angles. So just to give you the basics, we have this little gland in your brain called the hypothalamus. And there's a certain part of the hypothalamus that is controlling the release of the egg from the ovaries every month in your cycle. So it controls the menstrual cycle. And it works through this pituitary gland, which is kind of like the middleman. What happens is when you start menstruating, let's say you're, I don't know, 12, 13 years old, and every month you're releasing an egg, and you're releasing an egg, and roughly about 400 eggs you have. Okay, so when you exhaust 400, roughly you should be around 52 years old, and then your ovaries should stop working because you're probably not planning on getting pregnant, and so you lose the ovarian function. And with that comes a loss of certain hormones. When you lose the ovary and its hormones, thank goodness you have a backup organ called the adrenals. The adrenals make the same hormones as the ovaries, just not in the same amounts, the same quantities. During menopause, certain things can happen. Hot flashes, night sweats, anxiety, depression, stress, muscle loss, bone breakdown, all these things can happen. So there's various things that you can do to improve this whole thing. Typically, the first thing I would tell people to do is to strengthen the backup organ, the adrenals, and there's a whole bunch of things you can do, especially to make sure you're sleeping, make sure your stress is low, because we want to reduce cortisol, okay? And I'll put some links down below for information on that. And that may just solve the whole thing. The major storage site for vitamin E is the pituitary. So when you lose this cycle, okay, many times you can drop your vitamin E levels. And vitamin E is needed for all the sex hormones. So one remedy for hot flashes that's pretty effective is to take a very high quality vitamin E complex, including all the tocopherols and all of the tocotrienols together as one complex. Now, the other thing that works for hot flashes is taking iodine from sea kelp. Why? Because this helps estrogen dominance. Now, this is kind of strange because as you age, estrogen should decrease. It does. But the other opposing hormone called progesterone really takes a nosedive. So we have this relative severe progesterone deficiency with a moderate amount of deficiency with estrogen. And if we look at that ratio, it will give you an estrogen dominance. And so there's estrogen that's not being opposed or countered. It creates problems in this circuitry right here. Not to mention, if you have extra body fat, that body fat can then make more estrogen too after menopause and give you even more estrogen. So taking iodine can really work if you have an estrogen dominant situation. But there's some other things that also work for estrogen dominance. So let's talk about the liver. Now, the big purpose of the liver is to detoxify chemicals, poison, heavy metals, and excess hormones. It removes hormones if there's an excessive amount of them, as in estrogen dominance. It will also remove excess amounts of cortisol, just too much. But it can only do that if it's working. And the problem is when you reach age 52, many times the liver is either fatty or it has problems and it's just not working efficiently. So another solution that really, really is effective is to support the liver if you have hot flashes, night sweats, and issues. Because if we can get the estrogen to a normal level, you can actually resolve the hot flashes and be able to sleep at night. So there's a couple things you can do that are pretty effective. You can take cruciferous in a concentrated form, or even cruciferous vegetables, you know, kale, broccoli, radish, arugula, things like that. Or DIM, which is a concentrated cruciferous. You can get this in a supplement. Like one pill is equivalent to 2 pounds of broccoli. So it's a real good, helpful compound to detoxify the liver. But there's another really amazing remedy called calcium D-glucarate. Your body makes a little of this, but if the liver is not working, you might need more. You can get this as a supplement. I don't have a brand name to recommend. You can just look in different products and read the reviews. But what this compound does, it's very effective at helping detoxify estrogen and also ammonia if you consume too much protein. One study, it shows that it decreases estrogen by 23%, and it will decrease the receptors for estrogen by nearly 50%. Right there, it's going to pull you out of this estrogen dominant situation. It also increases the liver circulation with very minimal side effects, if any. So I just wanted to create this video to give you some options to look at if you have hot flashes and try different things. Thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back
with another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.